Today, we're taking a look at teamwork.com. Now, teamwork.com is an Ireland-based project management software, and it's designed to help you and your team to better organize yourself. We're going to overview everything from the pros, the cons, to all of the elements like pricing and details like that, showing you how it works as well, to see whether it's a right suit for you and your team, because there's loads of these project management software apps and tools, and it's important to get the right one. If you're new to the channel, do subscribe. And if you are looking for project management softwares, including teamwork.com, you can find all the links to this video, including alternatives to teamwork.com that you'll find linked below. We are Toolfinder and helping you to find the best tools on the market. So let's dig in and jump over to the software and really start digging into it, starting with some of the pricing. So here we are with Teamwork. And the first thing to dive into is the pricing side of stuff. They have a few different pricings. For this, I'll be demoing the, I believe it's called the growth pricing, and I will be on the trial. So per month, there's a 20% discount on annual savings. You'll get to see that it's pretty simple in terms of what it's offering. You get pretty much the project management templates, the workload resource planner, the budgeting and finance, and many other abilities, including advanced storage and automation limits. Now, to indicate quite clearly, there's actually a minimum of 3 people on this one and a minimum of 5 people on this one. So you do need at minimum to be paying the figure down here. So that's just something to note as well. Now you can see that all plans come with the unlimited free collaborators if you're looking at guests in your account as well. So that's great news when you're getting started with sharing with external people. Now obviously this is designed a lot for clients. And before we begin, there is a desktop app on Windows and Mac. To be honest, it's not that impressive. It won't do anything that you wouldn't expect. For example, it won't have an offline mode. The web version is seemingly a little bit faster than what I found with the Mac version. So as you can see, this is what the account looks like. And this is the home area. This is where you're going to see all of your stuff. So you're going to have my work, my calendar, my timesheet, inbox, projects, activities, and dashboards. And this is basically your hub of things to do. And up here is a sort of a skip experience. So if you want to see what's overdue, what's upcoming, what's today, then you can sort of skip by all of these elements and just find it straight away, which is an incredibly useful feature. So as you can see here, I've got announce on social media, which is part of the project site launch. Now I can do a few things here. I can include estimates, start organizing a reminder for myself, even add comments and even start a time log, etc. And all the regular stuff you'd expect to see. So that's quite good. And I can simply just tick it off. Now, if I go into a task detail, you can see more about it. So obviously I can start logging time. In this case, I could say, okay, I spent 2 hours on it this morning and indicate that for 10 a.m. this morning. And I finished it, not at 10 a.m., but I say it to 11:25 a.m., which gives me 39 minutes on it. But you can also mark it as billable, which hooks up with the invoicing later on. Now, obviously, I can mark this task as complete, but in this case, I actually don't want to. I want to just log that time and have that available down here so I can see. So the good thing is, if you do work outside of time, taskteamwork.com, then you can actually log stuff for it later, which is very helpful. You can edit all the task details as well as start a task timer here if you did start working on that task in real time, as well as some of the attributes here. For example, I could put an estimation of 2 hours. So obviously I'm probably about a third of the way through it. My maths isn't very good. And you can also indicate a high, medium and low rating as well. Now, if you want to, you can also set that progress. So if I was saying I was 30% of the way through it, that might be helpful for other team members to see, as well as initiate stuff on. Now, from this My Work area, you can change things about. For example, you can also add personal tasks, but you can narrow things down. For example, if you wanted priority over here and assignee over here, then you can start to see the details in a more customized view. You can also use the filter as well. So this My Work area is actually quite helpful. You can also see a timesheet. In this example, obviously, I've got 39 minutes logged here, but I can even see it in a calendar view as well, which is a relatively new feature. And as you can see, it demonstrates it on the calendar so that I can see it in real time. Now, if I were to drag an item on there, this is a great way to just log time. And especially if you're working with clients or specific people, then obviously marking it as build time is going to save you more time and being able to track that. Now, this is my calendar view if you did want to time block. Time blocking is a technique that a lot of people like. For example, if you were thinking, okay, I'm going to set aside 2 hours to schedule this. And as you can see, the time block is scheduled after the due date. So in this case, the due date is after, but if I actually put it in between 4 and 5, then what it's probably going to do is actually be a little bit more happy. It's going to be happy with me. And as you can see, because it's 2 hours long, it's going to separate into 2 tasks for me to get working on. So I can also connect my calendar, and I have a Google Calendar and an iCal feed. And you can customize this if you want to, showing weekends if you work them as well. And you can see all of the other details up here, as well as the projects you're associated to. So let's go to the projects area, because this is where you're going to be doing the majority of your work. And as you can see, the projects area is pretty much what you see with other project management softwares. You've got a list view, which allows you to see more of a sort of, I guess, list type structure, more like a to-do list application in terms of its structure. You've got a board view, which is great for Kanban, in which you can move stuff between the different items, and that's good for pipelines. You can also set up automations here as well, and there are limits on how many automations you can actually have, so it's worth checking those out. You've got a table view, which is sort of like that list view, but a little bit more structured and one that you saw as part of the account, but you can still modify details without going into the actual task. And you can see just your tasks or everyone else's tasks as well. There are also different task lists here. For example, you can say announcement, and you can choose from the templates, but you can also add the task list. Now this lives as a separate thing. So for example, if I was bringing an item over to it, you just do drag it across, which is quite helpful. Now the dashboard view is great for projecting up on a company whiteboard or TV that you might have to see how a project is going. But this can be incredibly helpful for working with clients because you could see how much build time is being progressed as well. Now, obviously you can customize this how you like a bit more, but it's actually fairly basic in terms of what you want it set up. You just sort of have to choose which attributes you most want to track. So for example, in this case, if you checked on an update, you can add a project update here, which is great for you and your team to see or what's happening as you go. Now, files is collectively what files you've added to each of the tasks, and time is a great way to see those build times that we mentioned earlier, but that's project associated. Now, there's a deadline element as well, which is helpful. You can see what task lists are associated and what tags are associated for organization. There's also forms as well, which is a great way to gather feedback, of course, and you can customize them quite at a high level of detail. As you can see on this left-hand side, there's even styling as well. These are simple forms, they're not going to replace someone like Typeform, but they are going to give you the ability to insert tasks directly into your project. And that's helpful if you're working with people externally as well. Now, as you can see, there's messages, and this sort of leads on to the chat ability. On the left-hand side, you can have chat, and this is something you can actually enable as part of your settings. So in this case, there's a fully separate chat application that you can access. So in this case, this is what that looks like. However, inside of settings, you'll need to sort of add this on as a bolt-on experience. You can see that integrations, you can see that chat is enabled, you can disable it. There's also spaces as well. You can also enable a bunch of other applications like QuickBooks and Document Editor, but there's also a desk experience, which is good for customer communication. But obviously you need to make sure you know how that affects your plan, because I believe the pricing is slightly different. So that's important to note, because obviously teams can now use this micro chat feature to start a conversation with somebody, which is great. So it's almost like having the ability of having a micro version of Slack within your account, which is really good. Now going back to this, you can see any messages that have been created, but you can also see comments, notebooks that have been added, links, and finances. Now finances is great if you're wanting to create a budget for everyone. So for example, if you want to add a fixed fee, for example, a build amount of time, You can then have, say, £2,000, and you can add a start date for this being today and create the budget for it. Now, the reason a budget could be helpful is you don't want to go over on certain clients that you're working with, or even a project that you're working with as well. So for example, if a new cost is logged or an expense, then you can keep track of it here as well. And you can see upcoming budgets as well from here. So the added view, you can also see a risk view. You can also see proofs, which is great for social media and marketing. And you can also see the people involved, as well as modify the settings in quite a high level of detail. For example, you can change the category, and with multiple lists, this can become incredibly valuable. You can switch on and switch off certain features as well, which is very helpful, and even prioritize certain features like Gantt view, which might go unnoticed, but your team might find it incredibly valuable. So you can start to see that this is incredibly helpful. And in this left side, you can also not only see projects, but you can also see the clients that you're working with and what projects are associated to them. This is great for breaking things down and making sure that people are actually working on the right things. But resourcing is also a feature that's available in that grow plan that you can use. So for example, in this case, you can add certain people and tasks to their list. So for example, remember earlier we added that 2 hours here? That is because I added 2 hours to that announce social media. Now, if I had a whole team here, I'd be able to see 10 hours for one person, 4 hours for the other person, and I could resource manage that, which means that I can move things around for other people that are getting overloaded by certain things. So this is called a workload management system and can be incredibly helpful. You can also do this to seeing what the schedule looks like and in terms of the allocation for a certain project, as well as a portfolio as well, with all of the project details in there too. Now, you have an area as well to see the manage things, and you can pin and unpin certain things if you want to. And you can also see approvals as part of the scale plan for time off and billable hours as well. Now, this is really good if you've got somebody in your team who has billed hours and you're not happy with how they've billed those hours, or you just want to set up an approval process as part of that. So obviously, all of these can be accessed on the left-hand side, including a reporting system, which is part of this account. So for example, you can see at a glance how projects are going as well. So this is really helpful because if you have a start date and an end date, you can get an indication of how far you are actually away from your projects. So you can see 4 days left, what is being completed so far. And as a manager, you'll be able to get a health indication so that you can zoom out, see exactly what projects need your attention and assistance, maybe unblock some of the road path that's there. You've also got an everything area, which is going to be helpful for managing everything like that. So this is obviously a tool that's designed for clients and those who work in marketing, sales, and externally as well. The billable features are really helpful for working with clients, and being able to resource manage as well is pretty good. The pricing is fairly reasonable too, but of course, if you compare it to some of the other applications that are on the market, it is a little bit more expensive than what I've seen, but obviously it depends on whether you're using these type of features working with clients. So obviously it's important to establish which things work well. I was impressed particularly at this ability up here. I haven't seen a way to narrow down your tasks and milestones really, really fast. That's something that I really liked as part of the account. And also, I did like the fact that you can go into this area and see more details like the financing and budgeting, which is sometimes crammed into a board-like experience like this and not really given much attention in a project management software. But having this is actually quite nice to be able to track the invoices and the expenses as well allocated to it. So hopefully this gave you a better overview of Teamwork. You can find it linked below if you're interested, and will help you find the best project management tool if you're still looking for it. So head over to toolfinder.co and you'll find project management tools that are right for you. And if you're wanting to check out Teamwork, you can find the link below as well. Thank you very much, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.